This video is brought to you by the Brown Lab at Virginia Tech. Hey everyone, this video tutorial is going to go over how to download and install ChimeraX, as well as an overview of the user interface. You can use the chapters or the timestamps in the description to skip to each part of the tutorial. Links to everything will be posted below. The link in the description will take you to this page right here where we can download ChimeraX. Now I'm using a Windows computer, so I would use this top version right here. But if you're using Mac or Linux, you can go ahead and click the drop down in the left under operating system and select the proper version for your computer. I'm going to select the Windows version and we're going to go ahead and accept the license agreement. The download should start automatically. If not, go ahead and click that link. And we'll skip ahead to when it's downloaded. Okay, once it finishes downloading, we can go ahead and run this exe file. Go ahead and accept the license agreement and allow it to run on your computer. The defaults here are fine, just take note of where you're installing it. The rest of these defaults are fine as well. Go ahead and install. We can go ahead and finish, or if you're ready to open Chimera right now, we can go ahead and hit start. Now this doesn't always work. If it doesn't, no worries. We can just go down here to our search bar and find ChimeraX. Go ahead and open it. And we're ready to go. Let's start by familiarizing ourselves with the user interface. The main interface, highlighted in red, shows the model of the protein or DNA. Here, the model can be moved around using the mouse. The view it shows is what the image will look like if a snapshot were taken at that moment. The command line, highlighted in green, allows commands to be typed rather than clicking buttons in the menus. The command line allows you to alter the default parameters used by the buttons, giving you more control. You can learn more about how a command works by typing help and the name of the command. This will bring up a page with information about the command and how to run it. The graphical menu, highlighted in purple, contains settings which primarily change how the model is displayed and visualized. Note that on Macs, these menus are not organized in the same way, but still contain the same options. There are other menus, highlighted in blue, that have various functions from graphical changes to structural predictions. The model panel, highlighted in orange, gives a summary of the models in use during the session. This section contains information about model names, ID numbers, color, visibility, and selection status. The log, highlighted in yellow, provides a history of all commands and actions taken. The log shows exactly how each action would be performed using the command line. This allows you to replicate a certain instance by copying and pasting from the log into the command line. The log also displays information about each chain and model when they are loaded. Note the log does not save when Chimera is closed. Thanks for watching. Be sure to watch the next tutorial in which we learn more about the user interface and its options.